2020, Tipuni Kōkiri, Māori Land Court and What Matters Limited join forces to develop and deliver an information-giving workshop to help whānau start their papakāinga journey. And then came the COVID. So, not wanting to let this ngangara deter us, we have produced our introductory workshop into this three-episode web series for you to access at your leisure. Papakāinga means many things to different people. From a traditional Māori settlement on ancestral land to the home base. From communal Māori land to original whānau homestead. But the common pātai for many whānau is, how can I and what do I need to do so I can actually live on my whenua? This three-episode web series aims to give you the first steps in papakāinga development. The 101 guide, if you will, just to get you started. Beginning with episode 1, whānau, where Bettina will give you a few tips on what you and your extended whānau should be having a kōrero about. In episode 2, whenua, Kath will give you advice on how to navigate the Māori Land Court system to legally and fairly prepare your inherited land interests for papakāinga development. Hone will present episode 3, Whare, where he will walk you through what the Tipuni Kōkiri Papakāinga program can offer whānau and give you some advice, resource links that will hopefully make the journey a lot smoother. Get their whānau, it is beneficial on your papakāinga journey to kōrero to others, research and review all the information you can to ensure you and your whānau are ready. And one thing to remember is that papakāinga development is not a quick nor is it an easy process, and there is a lot of things you will need to do. But kia kaha, take the lead for your whānau. Hapū, iwi, and make use of the opportunities to enable you, your whānau, and your future uri to live on your whenua with your whānau on your papakāinga.
So, who is your whānau? Sounds like a stupid question, but be honest. How many of you know who you share whānau ties with on the whenua you belong to? Our advice as step one would be to go to one of the following links, Māori Land Online or Tipu NZ, and type in either your parents' or your grandparents' name or the name of the block you think you whakapapa to, and check out 1. If you do actually whakapapa to that whenua, that you have the right block. 2. Do you need to succeed to your tūpuna shares? 3. Are you listed as a beneficiary of a whānau trust on that whenua? 4. Is there an overarching ahu whenua trust governing the whenua block? Then save or print out the list of schedule of owners and check out how many owners there are and who you need to start having your papakāinga dream kōrero with. Both these sites will give you this information. And in webisode 2, our Māori Land Court whanaunga, Kath, we'll explain all of this in a little more detail, so don't forget to watch that one. We are talking papakāinga, housing on multiply owned Māori land that you and all your whānau have whakapapa to. Step 2 is about reaching out to your whānau and encouraging them to be part of the aspiration, the building, the planning, the renaissance, the dream and desire to live and contribute to your collectively owned tūpuna whenua. Note down your individual whānau aspirations. Research what others have done around the motu. Then call a whānau hui. Let them know your dream and start developing a master plan. Ask them what their dreams are for the whenua and go from there. Slowly, building interest, momentum and tautoko. This may take more than a few hui And a lot of kaha to keep whānau interested. You might end up being the only one who is really keen, ready, or believes. But kia kaha, stick with it, as there are usually at least some of your whānau who have had the same dream for their whānau as you. And even if they're not ready to move yet, hopefully they'll still support you and your desire to return to the whenua and want to contribute to the overall master plan development of the whenua block. Kōrero about things like aspirations, houses, māra, rongoa, business opportunities, communal spaces, then move into dreaming about what types of housing and developments exactly. Kaumātakuia homes, whānau homes, sustainable homes, alternative energy, using your own whānau to build houses. Marae, swimming pool. Remember that whānau planning is intergenerational. So what are your dreams for your mokopuna? Step 3 is about establishing really solid, frequent and transparent communication with wider whānau. There is nothing worse than hearing about things you never knew were happening and vice versa. Whānau dynamics can sometimes be really tricky. So to ensure everyone is up to date, the best way is to set up a communications plan. Set up regular whānau hui, set up a Facebook, Instagram, email and phone number list, messenger and text groups, a YouTube channel, basically anything that will allow you to communicate with as many whānau members, shareholders and beneficiaries as possible so that you can share things that you are working towards and encourage them to be involved. Like we said in the beginning, returning home and papakāinga development is definitely not a fast-moving kaupapa, and let's be honest. Sometimes working and just having kōrero with some whānau is, well, just too hard. Even harder when you don't really know them, or you've returned home from somewhere else, or you weren't born or raised there. But remember, those other whānau lines could be your grandparents' siblings' kids, or your great-grandmother's whāngai siblings who you never knew about, or as close as your first cousins or your own brother and sister. Although this can be complicated, he whānau kē. Whenua Māori is collectively owned and your whakapapa is intrinsic, and papakāinga is about collective thought, living together and looking after each other as a whānau. And sometimes we have to be reminded and refocus some of our thinking around individual home ownership. The what's good for me and mine thinking versus whānau papakāinga development. Having regular wānanga, keeping in contact, and building a master plan together will build whānau relationships, even if it takes a while, possibly years. But really, what could be better than having begun or re-established those close whanaunga ties? Living together on papakāinga is really just the next step.